Dear students, today we are going to discuss about differentiator simulation by using PSPICE. So let us go to the screen. That is, first of all, we have to select ORCAD Capture. So we can select OK ORCAD Capture. So this window will be opening. Then select File, and in that New, go to New Project and create a project. First of all, you have to select the location where you want to save. Now here it is saved as, we have selected the location E. In that you can type the name of the new project. Here we are going to do differentiator. So let us type differentiator 2. Okay, then click OK. Then click on create a blank project, then OK. Okay, now this screen will be appearing. Now you can draw the circuit diagram here. So it will contain, in the case of a differentiator, it will contain a capacitor, resistor. So for selecting the part, you can type P. So this window will be appearing. Then for selecting resistance value, click R on the keyboard. So the resistance part will be appearing. Let us wait. So different resistors. So select R analog, then click OK. So this resistor will be appearing, then click OK. You can click on the screen, so this resistor will be here. For rotating the resistor, for rotating the resistor, you can type R on the keyboard. So click R on the keyboard, so this will be rotated like this. You can drag the resistor on the screen by clicking on that. Now select a part to select the capacitor. So type C there, then OK. So capacitor will be coming there. Then for escaping from this part, you can click on the escape button on the keyboard. Now you want to give the input sources, so you can type V pulse, then click OK. V pulse, click OK, so that you will be getting a square wave or pulse input. Then click OK. So that voltage source will be coming here. Then escape, press escape. Then you have to wire, so you can click W on the keyboard and you can draw the wire from one node of the component to other node. So like the way you can wire the circuit. Then escape. Now you can have to place the ground. So select ground and then click OK and place the ground there. Then escape. Next, you have to give the input variable, so double click on that variable and you can type and then OK. Then double click and type the value there and OK. Then again TD, double click, then 0, OK, TR, double click, 0, click on TR, OK, then TF, that is fault time 0, OK. Then pulse width, that is a half pulse width, that is 0.5 millisecond, that is 0.5 m, OK. Then period wait T, then click on pulse width, it is 0.5 millisecond, half pulse width is 0.5 millisecond, click OK. Then double click period, period is 1 millisecond, then click OK. So now you have given the input waveform. Next, you have to give the value for capacitor, that is capacitor value is, click on that capacitor value. That value is equal to 2.2 nanofarad, so 2.2 N, OK. Then resistor value is 5.6 kΩ. 5.6 K, then OK. So now the circuit is complete. Then you have to select the input and output nodes. Before selecting the input and output node, you can first go to the PSPICE and a new simulation profile. In that you can type the name. Let me type differentiator again. then create, then OK. And here you can type 5 millisecond, 10 microsecond, then OK. And next you can place the input and output node. For that place net alias. Net alias, first we are placing the input. So that will be appearing at the input side. Then escape. Then again place net alias from the tool part. We can type output there and we can place it on the output side. So that waveform will be appearing with this name. Okay, then escape. Okay, you can place the node voltages. You can see. So that is for input and other one is for output. Okay, then escape. So now the circuit is complete. Now we can run or we can simulate it. That is the button to run the PSpice. Now output waveform will be coming with names, input and output. You can see here the green lines shows the input. Because we have named it as input, that is why that name came there. Similarly, red lines shows the output. And we have typed the output in the net aliasing tool. So that is why that name comes there. You can see that the output waveforms for the differentiator is a spike. You can see that. And it appears at the changing time for the square wave. That means from 0 to positive voltage, a spike will be appearing. From positive to negative voltage, a negative spike will be appearing. So this is the exact waveform for the differentiator. And you can design or you can simulate the circuit for different values of capacitance. So the spike duration will be different. Okay. So that's all about this differentiator circuit. Thank you.